workshop has brought together a large and diverse group of people who can play a very constructive role in building peaceful societies by preventing incitement to violence, extremism, and intolerance. Friends, violence and interracial and interreligious hatred are as old as the human civilization, religious communities. Since then, somehow the popular discourses have mostly projected religion as the cause of conflict. Names of religions have been stained by associating them with terrorism. Islam, which is a religion of peace, had been perhaps the worst target. In the process, the other positive dimensions of religion have been severely downplayed, and the potential peacemaking roles of the religious leaders have been grossly neglected. There are many instances where the religious leaders and institutions played significant role in stopping conflict and preventing potential violence in the society, although the recognition of such dimensions of religion is rare. We are happy to see that the international community now recognizes the role of religious leaders in establishing peaceful communities, and the UN is now guiding national efforts to achieve those goals. I would like to thank Mr. Adama Dieng in particular for his devotion in fulfilling the mandate of his office and for playing a very proactive role in the prevention of mass atrocity crimes. Dear participants, Bangladesh was born out of a heroic liberation war fought by its people under the leadership of the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, against those who continuously undermined our racial and cultural identity. Pakistani rulers have tried to suppress our diversity, progressive ideology, and rich social and cultural heritage. We know better than anyone the importance of tolerance and peaceful coexistence in a society. Religious freedom lies at the root of our socio-political existence. Guided by the principle of peace of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, his daughter, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, has continued to promote pluralism and religious tolerance in Bangladesh society and its body politic. The motto of our government in promoting freedom of religion or belief is to each his or her religion, but festivals belong to all. That is the motto enunciated by Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. Bangladesh is one of the few countries where Eid festivals, Durga Puja, Buddha Purnima and Christmas are celebrated with equal fervor and observed as national holidays. In fact, Poila Boishakh, the first day of Bengali New Year, has now become the biggest national festival for the last few years. Ladies and gentlemen, Bangladesh too has seen, briefly though, rise of extremism in its society. Primarily motivated by some anti-liberation political elements, those acts of terror and targeted killings have only strengthened our resolve to eradicate fanaticism and religious intolerance from our society. After the terrorist attack on the Holy Artisan Bakery on 1st of July 2016, the government of Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has taken extensive counter and preventive measures against terrorism and violent extremism. We have undertaken massive awareness programs to encourage practice of tolerance, inclusiveness, and cultural activism in the society involving women, youth, and community leaders. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has particularly called the teachers and imams to play the lead role in preventing religious extremism. Recognizing the role of women in peace building, we are currently in the process of developing National Action Plan on Women, Peace and Security, which will further consolidate women's role in preventing violence and building peaceful communities. The Digital Bangladesh campaign of Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina is specifically designed to engage youth in constructive activities. I take this opportunity to express our gratitude and thanks to Mr. Adama Dieng for his kind words of support to Bangladesh for her efforts to protect the Rohingya refugees. Ladies and gentlemen, people of Bangladesh typically use religious norms to guide their day-to-day action, and as such, religious leaders are highly respected and are influential members of a community. Their unique positions of trust and respect enable them to provide feedback on any changes at the local level and communicate local priorities to government officials and development professionals. Recognizing their role, our government have long been promoting the engagement of religious leaders and actors in preventing violence. We have welcomed the Fatwa of Peace for Humanity announced by the Bangladesh Jamiatul Ulama Bangladesh, and endorsed by 100,000 Islamic jurists, scholars, and clerics, which teaches the peaceful and non-violent nature of Islam. The government has also taken an initiative to build 560 mosque-based Islamic cultural centers at district and sub-district level to promote Islamic values of peace and tolerance among the people. Distinguished guests, this workshop is a golden opportunity for the religious leaders and actors in Bangladesh to project their leadership roles to the new generation and encourage them to join the path of peace and harmony. I hope the speakers in the next sessions will highlight the good practices and also identify the areas where stronger engagement is needed. I wish the workshop all success. Joy Bangla, Joy Bangladesh.